How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to another narrated battle. This time it is some DDT because I feel like narrating some DDT. This was a battle. Indeed. this was a battle against my friend, one of my good friends on YouTube called Belgian Extra Large. He was been always using some, what's called, weird stuff, weird sets and such. And when he realized that there exists something like done deal here, he was like, God damn it, I have to join this. And exactly, it's what he does. The team preview. There's a Magneton. It's illegal with Eviolite in this tier. So he probably has the Volts. He's probably Scarf for specs. So I have to be careful with that. This is a threat even without the Eviolite. Then he has a Ninetales, which I don't really know what he's going to do with that. He's the Flashfire one, probably. And then he has a Beaverell, like me. And then he has a probably a Tangela, specs or bulky, but looking at his team, he looks like one of his walls, and the other one, it's Ferocid, and he has great coverage, I know, weakness coverage with Ninetales and Beaverell like for fire type attacks, I guess. And then he has a Sableye, which has Simple in DDT, so I don't really know what this thing's gonna do either. In my team, though, I got Beaverell. It's a pretty retarded set. It's a Charge Beam, Simple, Rest, Leap, Talk, like fantastic. Norman was the same with Beaverell, and you know, there is that. Then we have Rock Polish, Golurk. I don't run it's Iron Fist. I run Shadow Punch and Drain Punch, Rock Polish and Substitute. I don't run Earthquake because I don't know, it's just DDT is so much standard, I guess. Yeah, it's too standard for me, I guess. I decided to not run Earthquake and Golurk. Why? We'll never know. Then we have Mega Meganium, which is a Swords Dance Meganium with Seed Bomb and Earthquake. Great coverage, grass and ground. Then we have Sebastiodon, Special Defensive Wall, which does nothing in this match. Nothing. And then we have Norman, which is the fantastic set, but with special defensive and just the freed set, so with the ice attacks. And then we have a Sapsipper Azumarill, which again in this battle did nothing. So this will be recorded with the Windows media thing because it is one of these old battles that I got saved when the replays didn't work, and I'm sorry for that, but this is the last one, so you will never see those Windows thing again unless the replays didn't work anymore. So let's jump into the battle. So yeah, I'll lead with Frank, which is one of these Pokemon that I don't know what name to put, and I just put call him Frank, why not. I'm going to go for the shop and he switch out his Magneton, just scared of the Earthquake. And I'm bringing here my Azumarill, which has Sapsipper, so he tries to put the leeches on me, and that's why he failed. So yeah, I go for the waterfall, giving a nice amount of damage, and then I died to a thunderbolt, which is, you know, now I know he's not Scarf, he's probably specs. He's scared of the Equate, but again, I don't have it, so I can bluff it the whole battle. I can go for the Drain Punch and kill his Beaverell just the first turn he comes in. And when he brings his Sableye, I predict him to use Will-O-Wisp, and that's why I go for the substitute and then hit him real quick with that Fire Punch. And now he's gonna go Shadow Sneak. I know that, but anyways, I can make just do a sob, just sob down, because there's no reason not to. And then I go for the Shadow Punch to try that thing, but he brings this to try to take it. And then I go for the Drain Punch to get some recovery, because recovery is nice. And I'm behind the sub, so it's a free little bit of recovery for me. So yeah, I'm really keen to leech it now and bring Mega Meganium. And I'm gonna try to hit his incoming Ninetales with Earthquake, but he has a Balloon. So I am first to switch now, and he has a free sub, which is whatever. And he tries to go for the Disable, but he was first. He misclicked here, and I go for the Charge Beam to get the boost and break his Balloon, and that's what happens. And now I predict him to use Disable again, so I'm gonna go straight for the Surf and try to kill that thing. But he brings this, and Surf does nothing. So for some reason I go for Surf again. I should have switched, but I guess nothing wants to take a T-Ball that well. So he misses the Leech, and I get paralyzed. It was an amazing turn. amazing. And now he goes for the seed bomb, gets a crit, and almost destroys me. So that means even if I get another boost, which I do, I'm gonna die right now, which fuck this crit, man. Now Mega Meganium is here. I'm gonna go for the seed bomb. I don't know why. I should go for the earthquake, but I didn't. And now I go for the earthquake. So he's playing around my thing very well, but I'm getting some residual damage on him. He's trying to paralyze me, but I don't really care that much because I'm a bulky attacker. So I'm gonna go for the Swords Dance just in case he decides to stay in and maybe switch. And he has a Power of Punch Sableye, which was really cool when I saw that. But Meganium, man, you should have killed. And I get paralyzed when he recovers, which is bad. His Shadow Sneak though does nothing because I'm max attack. I'm max attack my HP, so I'm taking those hits live all day long. And I can kill him with Earthquake now, so yeah, nice job, Meganium. But now a Fire Blast is gonna decimate and burn my feathers, and I have to bring Frank again. So again, he's scared of the Earthquake, and I get more recovery with Drain Punch. And yeah. I'm gonna go for the sub right now, because I predict him to leech it and I don't have anything to take leech it that well. So I guess I can sub, and I'm just trying to just damage this thing a little bit. Because this is so hard. This is so hard to damage fucking Tangela that bad. Finally I can bring Norman on a lead sheet for free, not in a knockoff, and I can go for the Blizzard and kill him with a crit, which didn't matter. Now I'm trying to get my charge being up, which, you know, it's fine. Now I have to go for the rest, and this is a bit of a stupid part of the battle, just me trying to get an attack, and he just flash cannon all day long. He gets a special defense drop, which is bad, and again the rest on the sleep talk, which is even worse. And I'm not sitting comfortable in here, as you can see. Finally, I get a Blizzard off, which does a lot. I mean, he resists that, so wow. The power of Blizzard. Now I can bring Frank. I'm gonna go for the Drain Punch, and I'm gonna drain the soul of this little thing, which is beautiful. And now I'm sitting here pretty comfortable. He's gonna bring this, and he's gonna substitute, and I'm gonna Shadow Punch. But I'm predicting him to disable because he's running this disables head, and I'm gonna just put a Rock Polish off. Which was... This sells the end of the game, because now I just have to go for the Drain Punch. And clean the game! And at the end of the battle, I told him, dude, I don't have Earthquake. And he was like, what? How is that? Oh, god damn it. I was like bluffing the Earthquake the whole battle, and it didn't happen. Never. So yeah, check all the links from DDT if you're interested in, if you don't know exactly what it is. It's a really fun tier. It's a fun tier to be gentleman and have fun. Just not... Win is not your first objective. Just first objective is to have fun and just see new stuff. Just that is that what it is. So yeah, welcome if you're a new subscriber, because I have been just, you know, some of you are new here around, and I want to say to you welcome again. And if you're a long subscriber, give that like if you feel like. And just see you around on my next video, I guess. Bye. Yeah.